I was attracted to Burg Els or Castle Els in Germany because it reminded me of some Transylvanian Dracula fortress, but what I got was a Princess Disney fairy tale castle. Castle Els is located outside of town Wirsham between Bonn and Frankfurt. From Wirsham there are signs towards the castle, so it's fairly easy to find. There's a 2 euro parking fee at the parking lot, and from the parking lot there is a 4 euro fee to go with the shuttle bus down to the castle, but you can also choose to go for a 15 minutes walk down there. Sadly, drones are banned here, and they can do that because it's a private area. So, the first place here at Burg Els is here. There's a bend in the road and there's this quite nice overview. So, let's talk a bit about composition. You see here, if I zoom in a bit, like this, I've slightly underexposed it by like 1 1/3 stop to expose for the highlights, and you see the composition is very simple. We have the dark background, the forest, and then we have the castle standing out straight in the middle. Could zoom a bit in here and get a leading line from down here into the picture, but that's about it. It doesn't get more simple than this. There are a few trees here down in the foreground around the castle that I would want to get inside the frame. I always tend to get like at least something like this within the frame, so the picture can breathe per se. Yeah, so something like this is going to be my composition here. And you can also see I have actually attached my polarizing filter. There's quite a difference if I turn the polarizing filter off. See the sky here becomes more blue when it's on, and also the reflected light from the castle changes and the background changes too. So it makes quite the difference actually with the polarizing filter on. So something like this. So we have gone a bit further down the road from up there to down here, and as you can see there's a bit of traffic and a lot of tourists down here. I guess I will have to remove them in the post-production. But I actually kind of like this composition too. It's quite nice. I do cut the trees in the bottom, but I have to see when I come back at the computer what composition I prefer. Within the past years, Castle Els have become a very popular location to visit for landscape and travel photographers. When you see pictures from Castle Els on the social medias, they are often foggy and moody, and that was actually what drove me towards Castle Els in the first place. But when we visited, we had almost clear skies and daylight because we were on our way to Alsace, which was the main goal for that day. So we have found another vantage point from a hill. You basically just go down here, take this path here over a bridge, go up through the forest, and then you will find at some point some stairs. So it's pretty simple to find. Alright, so the composition here, it's not as good as the other one from the upper angle. From you can actually see it a bit over here was the first place. So, but here, not too shabby, but the other one was a bit better, that's for sure. So of course you can always try to be a bit creative and play around, like you can frame the castle with a few branches here. Not too shabby, introducing a bit of foreground. We have come down to another perspective, which is also absolutely gorgeous. Now this composition would look really, really nice. Like you can see we have like a backlit tree here, which is very nice. But you see, the entire point is that you want the castle as the focal point. And you see there's so many bright spots around it, like this one down here, the sky, the trees here. They would all take your attention away from the castle. On top of that, we are so unlucky that they're repairing the castle here. So we are not really... Well, I can remove it in Photoshop, but it's simply too much work. It's not worth it. But you see, if the sun was behind us, well, it's up there right now, here. But if the sun was behind us, this would probably look way better, way, way better. Now, just for the sake of it, to see what I can actually manage to do in Photoshop, because I really do like this composition, I will try to bracket this one and see what I can get from it. So, trying out a frame shot here. I see there's like a leading line up here to the castle, and then we have this branch here keeping it in. I don't know exactly how I'm going to crop it, or I'll just keep it like this. That's this plant up here. If the breeze will stop, it will just be still like here, so that can fill out the gap up here. Beside that, yeah, it's not really optimal, but let's see what will happen in Photoshop. Having walked a bit back and forth on that ridge, I actually ended up preferring this last composition the most. So all along the ridge here behind me, here, there is good opportunities for framing your shot. And I've tried out a few different things. And here's another one. And in the end, I of course wanted to get that one last famous viewpoint. Two leading lines into the castle with a strong central composition. It doesn't get more simple than that. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. It was a bit different than what I usually do, and I talked a bit more about composition, but I hope you also got a pretty good idea about your opportunities here at Burg Eltz. If you hit that little bell icon next to the subscription button down below, you will get a notification either here on YouTube or via Google each time I upload a new video. And as always, I would highly appreciate a like, and then I would like to know how do you like this format where I talk more about the composition and the pictures themselves. The next video will be the first video I've ever made from my own country, Denmark. And we're going to visit the probably most popular social media landscape location in Denmark.